So controlling S1, S2 and S3, S4 with single PWM is not efficient. Why not sufficient? Because IL equal to I load over 1 minus T. So, current will always be higher than load, no matter whether you operate in buck or boost. So, we need to control S1, S2, S3, S4 independently, okay, which mean S1, S2, I'll call it debug, S3, S4 deboost. Now, what will be the expression? V out equal to debug over 1 minus deboost into VDD. Now, if I want V out equal to VDD, what will be the debug and deboost? You can have infinite combinations, correct? 0.5 you can make both, then again you will end up having the same thing what you had earlier. Now, if I make debug equal to 0.9 and 0.1, V out equal to VDD. What is the current? Load the inductor current IL, how much? 1 over 1 minus 0.1, pretty close to 1.1 I load, only 10% increase. In the other case, it was 2x increase. So, how do we control this? So, there are three modes and this is called tri-mode buck boost. Instead of operating all the four switches simultaneously, we operate them based on in which region we are. Okay. So, we divide them in three regions: buck mode, buck boost mode and boost mode. Tell me, what will be the states of the switches in buck mode? You have the circuit here. Let me copy it. What will be the state of the switches? So, S3 is off, S4 is on, and now it will look like a conventional buck converter where S1, S3 will be PWM, correct, where D is debug. Okay. Buck boost mode. So, this case is V out is less than VDD. This case is V out is closer to VDD. How many switches we want to operate? All four or only two? In this case. All four switches will be operating here. Okay. So in this case, your V out is debug times VDD. So S1, S2 will be PWM buck, I would say, let us call it buck. Okay. S3, S4 will be PWM boost. V out will be debug over 1 minus deboost VDD. What about this case? S1 is always on, S2 is always off. Now it is looking like conventional boost converter, where S3, S4 is PWM boost. And your V out is VDD over 1 minus deboost. Okay. So, how do we decide when to enter which mode? Output? Okay. Anything else? So, we always define maximum and minimum duty cycle. So, when you hit the boundary, let us say my debug is limited to 0.9 and debug max and minimum deboost is limited to 0.1. Okay. So, you do not really need to look at the output, because this duty cycle may vary for the same output depending upon the losses. So, output will not tell you exactly the same thing. Let us say you have no load condition, under load condition, the duty cycle will be different for the same output. So, in reality you have to look at duty cycle when it is saturating. So, now you have so, this is, let us say, debug equal to 0.9, deboost equal to 0.1. Okay. Deboost equal to 1 and debug equal to 0. So, this is your buck region. Now, duty cycle is saturated to 0.9. Okay. When the duty cycle is saturated to 0.9, then you have no option but to enter buck boost, and here boost. So why can't we enter directly from bug to boost? Can we do that? Hmm? No, why twice? You start with 0.1, huh? When you go 0.9 buck, then you go to 0.9 boost from there. So, only 10% increase in the current, huh? Inductor current. Hmm? What is the problem with that? Hmm? What will happen to the output? Hmm? What will happen to the output?
Step.
It will remain same, it will change, what will happen? What is the output in case of 0.9, debug 0.9? Let's forget about the losses, just ideal condition. What is the output in case of deboost 0.1? 0.9? 1.1, huh? So, how much is that increase in output? Roughly 20%, huh? So, let us say I am operating at, so let us take an example. Let us say VDD equal to 5 volt. So, and sorry, Vout equal to, let us say, 1.2 volt, okay, and D is 0.9, debug 0.9. So, what will be the VDD? 1.2 over 0.9, how much? Or let me take a better example, because the devices you are using, a 1.8 volt fix, huh? So input hardly changes. So most of the input when it's changing, you will see with the battery voltage, lithium ion battery. So let's take the example of lithium ion battery. So let's say this is 3.3 volt, and now so what is the VDD here or battery voltage? 3.3 by 0.9, 3.67, huh? Correct. Now I am going directly from here to 10%. So your VDD is not changing. Let us say you are operating at VDD equal to 3.6 volt, my output is very well regulated at 3.3 volt, my duty cycle is saturated. Now I directly jump to boost, okay. So, boost mode, deboost. This is the minimum duty cycle. I cannot achieve less than this. So, I have to operate at 0.1, okay. So, what will be the V out? Because my VDD is not changing, correct? Tell me, 3.67 divided by 1 minus, how much is this? Okay. So your output will jump to 4 volt from 3.3 volt, 700 millivolt. Let's say you have a feedback loop, everything. Okay, feedback will try to recover. Okay, but how feedback will recover? In this case, you have a boost mode. So it will go to the buck mode again and it will do back and forth, and ultimately you will get a large ripple in the output. So it doesn't make sense to jump directly to boost mode, but to go to buck boost first.